Hello, NXT Universe. I'm McKenzie Mitchell, joined by a former NXT North American Champion and maybe the best dressed guest we've had so far on this show, Leon Ruff. Welcome. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me on.
Yes, of course. Glad to have you. So we don't actually have an official name for the show. It's kind of the beauty of it, but we've named it several different things throughout the guests that I've had. So with Bronson Reed, it was
Apron Hangs.
With Ever Rise, it was
Hot and Loud.
With Jake Atlas, is
What's Tea.
With Dakota Kai, it was
The Mac and Dak Attack.
So I want you to name the show for today.
We'll call it Ring Time with Ruff.
Ring Time with Ruff. That has a ring to it. I love it. And you named it just like that. So right off the top of your head.
You always gotta have something there.
Love it. So you are only 24 years old.
Yes.
And you are a superstar in WWE. How does it feel to be so young and be in the spotlight?
Honestly, it still feels a little weird because it's something that I was, you know, chasing and I was hoping for, you know, and sometimes I'll forget that I'm Leon Ruff.
Right.
And that I'll be on, you know, NXT, and then I'll notice, you know, people staring at me and I'm like, oh, that's right. You know, so it is a little weird. It's something that I get used to.
It has to be a surreal experience.
Yeah, it is. To see like my following go up, even from just the way people treat me now, you know, it's just way different.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Right after you won the championship, who was the most unexpected person to reach out to you and say congratulations?
So, when I won the title, when I came through the back, Triple H was one of the first ones. Like, he came up, pat me on the back and showed, you know, raised my hand. And that was unexpected, too. Shawn Michaels, I would have to say, because afterwards, and he was somebody that I looked up to, somebody that I watched. I seen him live, you know, and he was just taking a moment to tell me to enjoy the moment, let me know that I've earned it, you know. And that was really unexpected because I just didn't expect him to talk to me, like, one-on-one. Like that.
What about your family? I think you shared a photo of your dad with the championship. What was their reaction to you winning the title?
The immediate, like, when my dad, because he rarely shows emotion, you know. So I just remember when I called him and he was just so awake, you know. When he called, you know, let me see, you know, and he was just like, oh, so this happened when, you know, and then you did, you know. So he was doing a lot of that, and then my mom. I saw the video of her when she couldn't believe it, you know, when she started crying. And, oh, man, I'm getting emotional. Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
What? You gotta be kidding me!
When my mom, you know, she started getting emotional and she started crying. You know, it was a good moment. You know, I've disappointed my mom. Not a lot, but I know I have. And I know I have made her cry, you know, being a son growing up. But it was good to make her cry tears of joy.
What was high school Leon Ruff like? Was he outspoken? Was he introverted? Was he funny? High school Leon Ruff?
High school Leon Ruff was a hardcore scene kid. I was a skater kid.
Really?
In high school, yeah. So
okay.
I had
took me by surprise.
Yeah, I had long hair. I wore really tight skinny jeans. I had Vans. I skated. I was in the rock music. I was into it like really heavy. So I went to a lot of shows, a lot of hardcore shows and stuff. I wasn't popular, but everyone knew who I was. I was well received by ladies. You
okay.
know, that doesn't mean I dated
I love
a lot.
That.
A lot of people would underestimate me and things, and I would kind of just sneak up and take them by surprise. So like when I joined the wrestling team, it was my first time joining a sport and, you know, doing practice. And they kind of brushed me off, but I was the only one who could run the laps, the only one who can, you know, learn the moves and do them, you know, first try. And I was also able to hang in there with the with our team captain, you know, sort of stuff like that. So
what does Leon Ruff do in his free time?
Leon Ruff, I watch a lot of educational videos in my free time,
okay.
Which is surprising. And I'm also watching a lot of like old Disney Channel because, you know, I'm a huge Disney Channel, old Nickelodeon Cartoon Network.
What's your favorite?
I was a huge Hannah Montana fan. I was
yes.
a huge. I know that. She likes Zack and Cody, That's So Raven.
Oh, yes.
I was a huge Ed and Eddie fan. Jimmy Neutron, Timmy Turner, SpongeBob. Like, I like, you know, TV shows like that. Zoe 101.
What's something that you want to, that's a goal of yours here in WWE?
There's so many things that you can do in the WWE. And I didn't even think I would get the opportunity to win a North American Championship. And I did that. So there's so many like that is I don't know what I can't do here.
Yeah, I would love to travel with the WWE and see the world, because I didn't know much about geography until I started wrestling and noticing, you know, where the different states and the countries were and stuff like that. So I'm excited to travel.
Big aspirations, big future for you. Leon, thank you so much for sitting down with me this morning.
Thank you for having me.
It's been awesome, and we love watching you on Wednesdays on NXT.
Thank you.
Keep it up.